Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, students. Today, we will start from the very basics, like the three states of matter. Can you name them?
Yes, ma'am. The three states of matter are solid, liquid, and gas.
Very good. Are these states interconvertible?
Yes, ma'am.
The process of conversion of liquid to solid is known as freezing. The process of conversion of liquid to gas is known as vaporization, and the process of conversion of gas into liquid is known as condensation. Now tell me, have you ever observed the burning of camphor?
Yes, ma'am.
What have you observed?
Ma'am, on burning, camphor changes directly from solid to gaseous state without undergoing liquid state.
Right. These are the substances which are sublime in nature. In the process of sublimation, certain substances convert into gaseous state directly from solid state without undergoing liquid state. Now, can you name some other substances which are sublime in nature?
Yes, ma'am. Ammonium chloride.
Iodine.
Naphthalene.
Very good.
Ma'am, can you explain how can we separate sublime compound from non-sublime impurities?
Yes, sure. For this, we would require the following apparatus. Let us have a look at these. This is a tripod stand, a wire gauze, a china dish, a funnel sealed with cotton plug, a sand bath, some impure sample of naphthalene, a spatula, and a burner. So, let us begin the process. First of all, we will place the impure sample of naphthalene into the china dish with the help of a spatula. Then, we will place the tripod stand and a wire gauze over it. Now, we are going to light up the burner. Now, we are going to heat this impure sample of naphthalene over a sand bath with a funnel placed on the china dish. Let us see how we are going to do this. First of all, place the sand bath over it. Now, we will place the china dish over the sand bath and cover it with the help of a funnel. On sealing the ends of the china dish with the help of wet filter paper and on sealing the stem of funnel with the help of wet cotton plug, there is a decrease in temperature inside the funnel which help to fasten the process of sublimation. After 10 to 15 minutes, we will observe that the vapors of pure naphthalene will start to vaporize and they will collect on the inner surface of the funnel. So, let us wait for 15 minutes. As we would proceed with the experimental procedure, we will notice some vapors collecting inside the funnel and thereafter some crystals collecting on the inner surface of the funnel. The crystal in the case of naphthalene appears to be needle-like. Now we can see that the crystals are fully formed inside the inner surface of the funnel. Now we will see how the crystal look like. We can see the crystals of pure naphthalene over the inner surface of the funnel. Students, would you like to have a look at the crystals? Aren't the crystals pretty?
Yes, ma'am, indeed.
Students, you can also see that sand is settled in the porcelain dish because it is non-sublime in nature. In this way, we can separate sublime compounds from non-sublime impurities. So, have you understood this process of sublimation?
Yes, ma'am, but I would like to know why do some substances convert directly from solid to gaseous state without undergoing liquid state?
The reason behind for this type of conversion is that in sublime substances, there are weak intermolecular forces due to which they pass into gaseous state directly without converting into liquid state.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome, students.